Hello there, my Android trainees. Are you managing a sales team or are you part of the sales force yourself? And do you want to correct, improve, or level up your sales competencies? Hello, my name is mentor Myron Santana. Allow me to continue passionately, okay, discussing how you can master sales and everything you need to know about it. All right. So the next great tip I want to share with you would be master active listening. Okay, but what is active listening? Listening actively is listening to what your prospect is telling you or explaining to you and feeling their emotions as well. Yes, so you have to do both things, and that's what active listening is all about. Some people, they just listen to the message, right? But the thing is, they select what they want to listen to and they disregard their prospect's emotions or feelings, and that's not effective, okay? If you want to know how to better present your sales pitch and really convince them to buy from you or close a deal with you, then active listening is very important. It's much more important than you want to think it is, okay? So you really have to specialize in this. But how do you listen actively? That's the question. Let me walk you through what I self-conceptualized as the 9 F's of active listening. These are all words that start with letter F, okay? So number one, focus. So focus on the message. Don't select what you want to listen to. You have to digest every bit, every word that your customer or prospect is telling you, because you want to understand where they're coming from, right? Because the very first step of the sales process is customer needs analysis. How are you able to analyze their customer needs or requirements better if you're not going to focus on what they're saying, right? So this is about customizing everything, right? This is about really knowing and understanding what their problem is, what their issue is, what their question is, what their concern is, what their obstacle is, what their need is, so that you would know which model, what you have in your end, in your company, right, they need or they must have, all right? And that's not going to happen unless we focus on their message or their feedback. Now, it's not enough that you just focus on what they're telling you, okay? Because it takes out the human in you. So if you want to listen actively, you also have to feel their emotions. You have to be empathetic. You have to put yourself in their shoes, okay? So how serious is this obstacle, all right? How a must is it for you to, for your question to be answered, all right? So being empathetic is very significant. It's actually your way of building rapport, right? Making that connection with your prospect, because you're both strangers to each other. But if you're gonna make that harmonious relationship by feeling their emotions, then your customer or prospect is going to be your ally. And he or she will be the one to endorse you to whoever the highest or the best decision maker is. So that's how significant this is, okay? Now, the next F of active listening, guys, is fact find. Once again, this is about customer needs analysis, right? But how are you going to better understand what their issues are unless or if you're not going to fact find? So finding facts is about asking intelligent questions the right manner or way. Okay, so you really have to throw a good mix of closed questions, those questions answerable by yes or no, and open questions as well. Those what we call or pertain to as the W's and the 2 H's. What are those? What, when, where, why, who, which, and of course, how and how much. So go ahead and use your best judgment and ask whatever questions are necessary for you to get as much information as you can or want for you to customize your responses. That's what fact-finding is all about. All right, of course, there are instances in your interaction that you're not on the same page. You're not aligning yet, right? You're not completely understanding your customer's big picture. So what are you gonna do? You have to continue asking questions. So it's about following through or following up. So go ahead and clarify, all right? It will not hurt or harm. And remember this, guys, there are no dumb questions, only dumb answers, right? And for me, when somebody who's presenting a product or service to me is clarifying or asking follow-up or follow-through questions, I appreciate that person because, you know, that person is trying to understand everything and not just sticking to his spiels or scripts, okay? Remember that. Okay, the next F of active listening would be let them finish. One of the amateur mistakes of salespeople would be, you know, just blabbering, right? Just talking nonstop because they think they're the expert and that the customer just has to do the listening. No, okay? Of course, this is a two-way interaction, right? The one that's at the center of it all will be your prospect or your customer. So when your customer is telling you something or elaborating on something, right, you have to pause or stop. You have to take a step back, all right? Don't cut them off. Don't interrupt them. Don't talk over them. Let them finish. It's also a show of respect, and they're actually going to be more impressed when you do that, okay? So let them finish. The next F of listening actively, which is important in sales, would be never foretell. Never foretell. Foretell is predicting, right? Foretelling is assuming, right? So control your urge to trait that what your prospect is telling you is something that you've already heard, right? That it's not nothing new to you, okay? So you have to control your urge to assume in a negative way or to assume to a fault. You have to treat each conversation and prospect you're presenting to as unique and different from one another. So never foretell, all right? So from start to finish, focus on the message and feel their emotions, okay? You have to give them the benefit of the doubt. You have to ensure that you're not missing out on a very important element of the conversation, okay? Never foretell. Now, because of you focusing on what they're saying and not being a selective listener, feeling their emotions, asking the right questions the right way, clarifying, and ensuring that you're aligned with each other. And if you, of course, you're showing open-mindedness, professionalism, and maturity by letting them finish and never foretelling, not getting ahead of them to a fault, okay, then you are now able to formulate or think straight, think intelligently, so that you can come up with the best and the most intelligent response. And this response, or these responses, okay, would really convince them and really, you know, make them feel that they got hold of the right person, that they are being shown the right product or service that they really need or must possess in their company, and that it's gonna be worth it. It's a genuine investment, right? Okay, so formulate. And the second to the last F of active listening would be recapping facts. In any sincere conversation, two-way conversation that is, all right? If you wanna ensure that you're on the same page and that you're not forgetting something, right? This is what we call first contact or first touch resolution. That there's no need to, you know, inefficiently getting back to each other, okay, which is wrong and not effective, okay? You have to recap facts. So this is about providing a summary of what you guys have discussed, what you guys have committed to doing for each other, all right? What the next steps are, etc. So to ensure that there's gonna be a call to action, which is a very important step of the sales process, you need to recap facts, right? So, dear customer, these are the things you committed to do, and these are the things that I committed to do on my end as well. So, are we good? Are we on the same page? Do you have any follow-up or follow-through questions for me? Okay, you wanna clarify anything? All right, so that kind of an effective communication is done through recapping facts. All right, so let's just have a quick review. You wanna master sales? Master active listening. You wanna listen actively really well? You have to do the 9 S of active listening, which are focus on the message, feel the emotions, fact-find questions, follow through clarification, let them finish, never foretell, formulate with your best response, and recap facts. And last but not least, of course, there are times that when you are doing your sales presentation or pitch, you bring a laptop or a desktop with you or a tablet or a simple notebook, right? So go ahead and make the most of whatever tool or aid you bring with you, all right, in your conversation or interaction with your prospect. So that's basically what maximizing your forms is all about. Okay, so there you go, guys. Hopefully, because you already know how to listen actively with these 9 F's, that it will be able to enhance your likelihood of closing that highly coveted deal and really being able to convince or compel your prospect, okay? So if you appreciate this value-adding content and you want yours truly to enter train your salespeople on sales mastery, just get in touch with my team, and I'm very excited and I'm looking forward to mentoring you on your way to success.